How y'all doing, family? This is Chris Rod with Media TV, and I'm going to be coming to you with this video, family. It says, report black public students suspended longer than others. Of course. But y'all watch this video, family. I'm going to come back with my thoughts.
United will never be defeated!
A message shouted loud and clear on the steps of City Hall.
There are no more excuses, and we need you to stop talking the talk and start walking the walk.
Local leaders and youth organizations calling on the Department of Education to make a change across city schools after a recent study showed black students are often suspended longer than their peers.
Black students in New York City schools only account for 26% of the student population, yet miraculously account for nearly half of the suspensions.
The report released by the New York City Independent Budget Office focused on the top 10 violations that caused suspensions from 2016 to 2017 in grades 6 through 12, revealing black students get harsher punishments for 8 of them, and for 3 of the categories, bullying, reckless behavior, and altercation, they were suspended for roughly double the number of days compared to students from other racial groups.
This is something that we've been living with ever since elementary school. It's something that we've become used to, something we've come accustomed to, and it's something that just ain't right.
For reckless behavior, black students got suspended on average about 16 days, white students 11 days, and Asian approximately 7. The report did show that overall suspensions are down compared to years past, but local leaders want to see an even larger decrease, asking the city to put more guidance counselors and peer mediators in schools.
Instead of suspending kids or expelling them, the city should be guiding them. These are kids.
When you do things like suspend people first, instead of really get to the core of the issues and the humanity of the young people, right, you're not caring and you're not actually nurturing a holistic environment. It's time for folks to really step up.
They're also asking officials to shorten maximum suspension time. Right now, a long-term suspension can last up to 180 days. Outside City Hall, Rena Roy, CBS 2 News.
Okay, family. So, let me get on talk on the suspension thing, you know, because I already know, I experienced that shit, you know, everybody black, you know what I'm saying, experienced that shit, you know what I'm saying, but with that being said, for instance, I had an example when I was younger. This was like when, I think it was like first or second grade or something like that. This is when I was back, back home in New Orleans when, you know, when I was way younger and everything, and I was in the class. No, I wasn't in the class. Where was that? Yeah, I was outside. I remember this dude, this white boy named Derek. He was a little bigger than me, you know what I'm saying, at the time, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, we was outside. We was playing and shit like that. And I guess he thought I was scared of him, or he was trying to bully me or something like that. And I told the dude, I said, hey, bro, like, chill, you know? I told him, chill. I said, you know what I'm saying, stop and stuff like that, you know, because he was throwing some wood chips at me and stuff like that because we was by the swings. And he was throwing wood chips. I told him to stop. So I went and told the teacher and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying, because my mama said, go tell the teacher before you do anything. So I went and told the teacher and let her know, hey, you know what I'm saying, Derek throwing wood chips at me and stuff like that. And can you please tell him to stop before, you know, before I have to fight him? And she was like, oh, he's not going to do it again. So I go back by the swings and stuff like that, you know, saying by my friends and everything. And Derek throwing some more wood chips at me and stuff like that. I said, okay, bro. So me and him fought. I punched him right in his mouth and everything and shit like that. You know, I'm beating his ass up and shit like that. So, you know what I'm saying? They break up the fight and shit like that. You know, I'm sitting in a principal office and shit like that, you know. So, they have him come in first and shit like that, talk to him. Then they send me in there. So, it was like, Christopher, why did you hit Derek? Why did you knock Derek teeth out of his mouth? She was like, look what you did. I'm like, look, I told the teacher, Derek was messing with me and stuff like that. And the teacher didn't do anything. So I was raised, hey, you know what I'm saying? Don't let anybody put their hands on you and stuff like that and fight back. But if you're in school at the time, you need to make sure you go let a teacher know Let somebody know before you take it in your own hands and, you know what I'm saying, put that ass whooping on the ass, put that act right on the ass. So that, I was always told to do that. And I told the principal, and she was like, oh, Crystal, we don't condone violence and stuff like that. And you know what they did? They sent this motherfucker back to the class, and he not suspended, but I was suspended. But this motherfucker started the fight and shit like that, and he thought I wasn't going to defend myself. He thought I was just going to just go out the whole school year on him bullying me and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? But I get suspended like I'm the fucking bad guy because I knocked this fucking teat out. But they didn't understand who caused the fucking problem. You feel what I'm saying? They don't give a fuck. These people do not give a fuck who start the shit. You know what I'm saying? And our black kids get suspended for anything, any little fucking thing, for a fight. You know what I'm saying? They get more days off than white kids. We get suspended way more, especially if we sitting in a class or, you know what I'm saying, probably interrupting the teacher or something like that or whatever. We get suspended way more than white kids do. White kids could be disrupting the class and shit like that, cursing out the cheat teacher and shit like that. And would ignore them like they ain't doing nothing. But as soon as we cut up, oh, that's an automatic 5 days. Oh, that's an automatic in-school suspension. You feel what I'm saying? Anything we do, like any small thing we fucking do, you know what I'm saying, we get more punished, harsher than any other fucking race. And that's because these fucking teachers are motherfucking racist. The whole school system is racist, and they don't give a fuck. They don't give a fuck if they suspend you for 16 days. They don't give a fuck if they suspend you for 100 days. That's their fucking, that's the white school system fucking job, is to make sure that they eliminate the black kids from fucking learning. To put you behind even more and more. Okay, just send them home. Just send them home. Send them home. Not understanding the issue of what's going on and trying to find out the problem of why, you know what I'm saying, why they're getting in trouble and shit like that, and how they can help, you know, and help the kid so, you know, they can be better and be a better person in life. Oh, just send them home. We don't care. Just send them home. You feel what I'm saying? But it's with everything. It's not only with, you know what I'm saying, with kids in school. It's with, you know, work. You know what I'm saying? At your job and shit like that. It's with everything. These motherfuckers, like, just don't care. Anything we do, black people have to do, we got to work twice or three times as harder for anything we have. You know? Anything we do, we have to be the best at everything. But, you know what I'm saying, it is what it is. But my best bet to everybody is, if you're tired of sending your child to school and you know these people not fucking doing anything for your kid, homeschool. Homeschool, you know what I'm saying? That's always another option, you feel what I'm saying? Because these motherfuckers don't give a fuck when they disciplining our kids and shit like that. They don't give a damn when the fucking security guard officers be slamming our fucking kids and shit like that over the desk, swinging them around like they fucking grown and shit. They don't give a fuck about our kids. You feel what I'm saying? So if you can do homeschool and some, you know what I'm saying, like get some people together and say, hey, well, you know what I'm saying? You know, we can have homeschool at this place, and you know what I'm saying, you bring a kid over, I'll teach you and teach a kid and, you know, help you with homeschool and everything. And everybody just pay a little money, you know what I'm saying, every month for that person that's doing homeschool, and that's, you know what I'm saying, that's gonna be at the house and stuff like that. And you'll know that your child will be way safer in homeschool than actual fucking school itself, because they're not teaching our kids what they really need to know. But at the same time, it's our job to make sure that our kids know what they need to know and know what is going to help them through life. So, fam, I just wanted to leave that with y'all right quick and everything. And I hope y'all having a great evening. Love y'all, family. Subscribe to the channel. Smash the like button. And I'll be back with another one.